This is a quick guide to using the Edit in Place feature in Fusion 360. Right now, this is still a preview feature. So you have to go to your username, preferences, under preview features, check on Edit in Place. At the end of the tutorial, if you feel that you do not need this feature or you would prefer to use it only when it is fully released, feel free to uncheck this at the end of the tutorial. I have two components in the data panel, a cylinder and a hexagon. Let's open the cylinder. My plan is to insert the hexagon and use that as a cutting tool to create a recess on the cylinder. Make sure to activate the top level. Right click on the hexagon and insert into current design. This brings up the move copy window. I will just press OK to leave it in the default location. If the cylinder was active while you inserted the hexagon will have been inserted as a child component under the cylinder. Upon insertion, I realized that the corners of the hexagon are too close to the circle for my liking. I need at least a 5mm clearance. In previous iterations, you would have to open up the hexagon file to make the change. With the new Edit in Place function, you can make the change in this window and in the context of the cylinder. If you hover the pointer over the hexagon in the browser, an Edit in Place icon pops up on the right side. Clicking on that opens the hexagon file for editing. The cylinder becomes translucent, and a message pops up saying that this is an associative edit. We can create references to other components, and those references will be captured in an assembly context. Locate the hexagonal sketch in the timeline. Right-click and edit the sketch. Delete the existing dimension. We are going to define the size of the hexagon in terms of the clearance between the corners and the circle. To do that, we need to dimension to the tangent of the circle. Start the dimension tool, right-click on the circle, and select pick circle or arc tangent. As you hover over the circle, use the cross mark as a guide and snap to a point somewhere close to the corner of the hexagon. This does not need to be exact. Next, select the appropriate corner of the hexagon. Adjust the dimension accordingly. Let's also add in some fillets. I am done with the editing of the hexagon. Let's see the green check mark to end the edit in place. To use the hexagon to cut into the cylinder, we first need to activate the cylinder. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the cylinder as the target body. For two bodies, select the hexagon. Change the operation to cut. Hide the hexagon to take a look at the recess. Save the file at this point. Now, let's open up the hexagon in a separate window. If we look at the sketch, you can see that the cylinder has been projected into this file. You can see that the fillets have been added here also. Let's add some fillets on these two faces and save the file. If we go back to the cylinder file where the hexagon had been inserted, there is a warning that the hexagon is out of date. Just click to regenerate. You can see that the recess has regenerated accordingly. So to conclude, changes flow both upstream and downstream.